Are you ready to praise Him today? Come on, He's been good to us all week. Let's come together. Father, we love You. We exalt Your name. We lift You high, Father. We just pray that You would just come in this place, God. We know it's all because of You that we're here. So we worship You. We praise You. We exalt Your name, Lord Jesus. And let everything that we do and say give You glory, God. We pray that You show up in the new way.
Perfect. Won't You be the glory? Maker of heaven. relationship. His love is incredible, amen? It is awesome. Father, we just know we come before you and we lay everything down. God, our prayer this morning is that you would come and just mess us up, God. Get us out of the status quo. Get us out of the everyday routine that we're stuck in. God, come and just break our hearts, God. Break our idols, Lord, and let us just fall before you because your love is so incredible. You know, the great thing about his love is even whenever we want nothing to do with it, it still pursues us. It still chases after us. And I know I need that. The last couple weeks, my mind has been wandering. My mind has been all over the place, but knowing that his love is pursuing me still, there's truly nothing like the love of God. So God, help us understand that love. Give us a glimpse of that love and come and just change our hearts. But we want an encounter with you, God. We don't want to be up here and just sing songs, dance around and have a good time. God, we want an encounter with you this morning. Otherwise, it's just a bunch of noise, a bunch of nonsense, God. But we surrender our lives. God, come and do what you want in our lives. We worship you, God. Let's sing about his great love. Thank you.
the love of God today, but do we really understand it? I still think there's some people that think that they've crossed some kind of a line and it doesn't apply to them. I'm telling you, I love the next one, the words of this next song, because it says, His love never fails. It never gives up, even on the worst case scenarios. It never runs out. It's never gonna stop. You can never be good enough. You can never do enough good things. You can try as hard as you can, but there's nothing that can stop the love of God from coming down to you if you will open up your heart and receive it today. I'm telling you, His love never fails. It never gives up. It never runs out on anybody. Will you take that in today? Will you receive what God has for you? It's higher than any mountain, stronger than anything that can happen.
Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out.
tree just engulf you in his presence. Let the truth of these words just let you fall before our Father. As the Bible tells us, for I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love. Neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither fears for today or worries about tomorrow, not even the powers of hell can separate us from the love of God. Just let it overwhelm you this morning.
He loves us. left me. I didn't grasp how unconditional it was that he could never really love me any more than he already does. That his love would never get any less for me, no matter what I did or where I'd go. And he could never love me any more than he already did. That concept changed my life. That I didn't have to try to impress him. That I didn't have to try to prove to him. He just flat loves me. And he loves you. The Bible tells us in 1 John that the only reason that we even can love him is because we know that he first loved us. So often in church, it's always, you got to love God, you got to love God. We do love God the best we can right now, but if we can grasp how much he loves us, oh, how he loves us, then we'll automatically love him back. We can't help but love him. When we know how much he loves us. How many of you know that Jesus and God loves you? Come on. We say we do, but we got a long way to understand the height, the depth, the length, and the width of his love in our lives. He loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Brings tears to my eyes. Now that I grasp it and understand it. Too often we serve God out of guilt, we serve God out of a manipulation, we serve God out of trying to be something that maybe we aren't. But if we can do what we do because we know he loves us and we just respond to him, it makes life so much better and so much more meaningful. He loves us. I hope you know that today. God truly, truly does love you. Amen. That's why we can come today. That's the message today. We are called to be loved. Woo! What a concept. I'll tell you now, that's the first calling and purpose of your life. Why God created you. Because he needed somebody to love. Love is not love unless it can be given. God is love. Not God loves. God is love. And if you are the epitome of love, that's your character, that's your nature, you got to do something. You can't love without giving it away. So he created you, he created me. We're talking, what on earth am I here for? That God could love you. I'm not here that I would love God first. I can't even love God till I know he loves me. We love him because he first loved us. I'm here so that God, who is love, and have an object of his affection. Woo! That's powerful. That's why we were created. We weren't created to be his slaves, to be his servants. We weren't created to obey him. Those are things we should do. But our number one calling is to be receivers of his love. Not doers, receivers of his love. That's why you and I are on this earth. There's no purpose for mankind other than that he would have somebody to express his love to. Because he is love. Wow. Is that a different concept than the way you were raised and I was raised? You gotta love God. You gotta do more. You gotta... No. I've gotta receive more. I've gotta be the recipient because I'm the object of his love. Wow. That'll change your life once you get a hold of it. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. One of the responses I'm preaching in my sermon right now is that now we can come boldly to the throne of grace because we know he loves us. There's no doubt. I don't have to prove anything. I don't have to earn anything. I don't have to get any spiritual points to get my prayers answered. He loves me. He loves you. He wants to heal you. He wants to bless you. He wants to lift you. He wants to touch you. And it's not because you've earned it. It's because you were created and you're on this earth so he could love you. Woo! That's powerful. I said that's powerful. My God. Sing it again. Oh, he lift your hands with me. Praise him for it. that loves her, amen. Christy Bellinger's grandfather has cancer. He's been given 4 months to live. May the grace of God be upon him and the healing miracle power of a loving God be upon him. We need to regularly pray for those that minister in the prisons out of our church. So Tanya Brooks is constantly in touch with me as her pastor and is an extension of this ministry. God's using her mightily. They've renewed her commitment to be the chaplain of the prison. And she conducts the choir and leads the services and touches hundreds. I know Christy and some of the ladies went with her to this women's prison and were amazed at the effectiveness of what God is doing and using her. Let's pray grace continually upon her. Over Julian Garcia, the faithful member of our church for years, the full-time prison ministry, and God uses him. Randall Young goes to the jails and the ministry. We have so many that do that, and I just feel we need to cover these folks in prayer. And may God use people and touch them during this time. Charles and Jackie Baldwin's family, or grandchildren, just some different ones, just really needing some touch. How many of you have members of your family say, my family just needs help from God, needs the grace of God? I just mention them because they just, I just breathe their names in prayer. You have to know details of anything, but they just need the touch of God today. William, I believe that you are going to lead us in prayer this morning, my friend. Aren't you glad that we can approach the throne of grace with confidence and boldness because we know he loves us? So William, lead us. Join hands with somebody, if you don't mind, across the congregation. All of us as family of God together. Will you lead us in prayer this morning?
Your love never fails. It never gives up. It never runs out. We fail. We give up. We quit. We run out of people. We run out of relationships. We run out of our children, our marriages. We run out of ourselves. We even run out on you. But your love never fails. It never gives up. It never leaves us, never forsakes us, never runs out of energy. I thank you, Father, we thank you this morning for an unfailing love, a love that surpasses all human understanding. You are the pure essence of love. We thank you, God, that our minds cannot fathom the amount and the way that you love us. So, God, we thank you. We just receive this love. We stand as recipient vessels in need of receiving this love, not trying to earn it, not trying to buy it, not trying to bribe our way into it, just to receive it. Father, we fail many times. We fail and made many mistakes. We made bad